The owner of the car wash has kindly provided us with their surveillance footage. There was only one camera, but it might have picked up something useful. That little tear could have been caused by any number of things. See if you can narrow it down a little. That might give us a clue as to what exactly made that tear. Looks like there's some residue on it. Better get it analyzed. According to the timestamp on the surveillance footage, Jessica Marnier drives into the car wash at 9 p.m. Now, Robbins puts her time of death at somewhere between 8 p.m. and 10 p.m., so we're closer to pinpointing her exact TOD. Wait, what's that? Jessica appears to be wearing both earrings when she pulls into the car wash. And look, the GPS is in its holder, so it definitely got knocked out while Jessica was inside the car wash. Guillermo Rice. Veronica said they just call him Will, and he's Jessica Marnier's boyfriend. Looks like he's also familiar with narcotics. Mostly misdemeanor possession charges, no convictions. I'm gonna go out on a limb here and predict that the residue in that plastic bag isn't gonna turn out to be baking soda, but let's be totally by the book here and make sure it gets analyzed. Bags full of pure cocaine, and Jessica's boyfriend's prints on it. Benzoyl methylechinine and morphine, the speedball cocktail. But what's it doing in the tear on the headrest? Let's pay Doc Robbins a call down in the morgue. Hi, Doc. Got some more questions for you about the overdose case.
You've learned something new?
There was residue of benzoyl methyl echinine and morphine in and around a tear in the driver's headrest of our victim's car.
Interesting. It certainly suggests that the needle used to inject Ms. Marnier came from behind her. Well, if there had been a struggle, then I'd say it's very possible the syringe needle may have gotten caught in the fabric of the headrest. I'm just about to review my autopsy notes and re-examine the body. I'll let you know if I find anything else.
Let's hear what Will Rice has to say. We need a warrant, and Jim's our go-to guy.
Based on what evidence?
All right, so you have Will Rice's prints in the car and on a used plastic bag of cocaine, which was also part of the cocktail that killed Jessica Marnier. Nice work. I'll get you your warrant.
Good evening, Mr. Rice. Thank you for coming in to talk to us.
Yeah, well, it's not like I had a choice.
No, you're right. Courtesy has a way of getting trampled under the momentum of a homicide investigation.
Homicide investigation? I thought Jessie died of an overdose.
So you knew she was a drug addict?
She wasn't a drug addict, but yes, I knew she took drugs sometimes.
Mr. Rice, before we discuss your relationship with Jessica, we'd like to learn a little bit more about you. Records we have indicate you dropped out of college not long ago.
I did. I felt I was pretty much spinning my wheels in school, so I chose to get out into the real world. School of hard knocks, right?
Not if your parents are paying all the bills for you. What is it that your mother and father do again?
You leave them out of this. They're good people. They're hard-working people who took me in when I was a child and raised me as their own. Whatever this is all about, it has nothing to do with them. You understand? We were in love. We'd been dating almost a year, and we moved in together 6 months ago.
So things were going well?
Yes. Yes, they were. I wanted a future with her, but what's the saying? Man plans and God laughs. No one. The only thing I can think of... She only mentioned it once. She said she had a brother who was murdered. That's all she told me. She didn't want to talk about it. Do you think that might have had something to do with this? V and Jesse? Wouldn't call them close, but they got along okay most of the time. V and I sort of dated back in high school, so I think she could sometimes be a little overprotective. I was at our apartment, asleep.
Can anyone verify that?
I don't know. Veronica, maybe? Like I said, I was asleep. Look, I know you think I did this to her, but I could never hurt Jesse. I loved her. She was everything to me.
On a used bag of pure cocaine.
Look, we party. We like to have fun. We've done some coke. Together. No, that's not my thing. I seriously doubt it. But, you know, like I said, there were some things that she didn't want to share with me. It's not like she tried to hide that from me. It was just something she said she needed. Like a ritual. This? I've had it for years, but it's actually become what I like to call our communal sweater. Probably anybody who's ever been to our place has worn it at one time or another. Jesse used to say it was like a house pet that we didn't have to walk or feed or clean.
We're gonna need a sample of it. Well, Mr. Rice, at the very least, your print on the bag of cocaine is going to interest the district attorney. I'd say your continued cooperation with us might go a long way to convince him of your sincere desire to make amends. You can begin by providing us with your DNA, as well as permission to search your apartment.
Again, how could I possibly say no?
I finished re-examining the body, and I did find something important. A second injection site. It's situated high on the back of the victim's neck, concealed along the hairline. Based on the bruising around the wound, it would appear Ms. Marnier was injected in the back of the neck before she was injected in her right arm.
Red sweater somehow found its way to the crime scene. We need to ask Will Rice what he knows about it. Not many 20-year-olds can afford a place like this. Will's parents really take care of him. How we try to buy a child's love. All right, let's get down to business here. The warrant only gives us permission to search the living room and Will and Jessica's bedroom. Veronica's room is out of bounds. Wait a second, is that someone in the shower? We didn't recover Jessica's cell phone at the scene. This one may be hers. Let's get it back to the lab and run it and see who's left this voice message too. Is there something inside that book? Recognize who's in this picture? She may be 20 years younger, but that's Beatrice Salazar, the queen of the hive herself. She looks pregnant. Funny, I don't remember reading in the case file about her having a child. I wonder what this picture is even doing here. Look, dust the clippings for prints, then let me handle it from here. Until the sheriff and the FBI are on the same page with us, it's best if I take any heat on anything related to Salazar. Run that print. We'll keep searching the newspaper for more, but let's just see who else is interested in Beatrice Salazar. Good job. I don't think we're gonna find any more prints on that. Hair. Jesse and Will are both brunettes. Medicine bottle. Let's get it analyzed.
Jesus, who the hell are you?
We're from the Las Vegas crime lab. We have a search warrant.
Damn, you scared the hell out of me. I didn't hear you guys come in.
Excuse me, aren't you Manuel Molinas?
Yeah.
You're just the man we're looking for.